camera. Hey, boys, hey, girls. Every time I turned it on, he kept asking me to set the date, set the date. I didn't want to set the date. I set it to 2037 or some bullshit like that. Yeah, I'll be gone by then. We don't live forever. Oh, I'm kind of perturbed. Or should I say pissed off to the highest level of festivity? I made a nice dish last night. Cheese grits with shrimp. What was it called? Not wrong a lot. Cheese grits with shrimp in a, it went out that ear. Come here. Hold up, I'll think of it in a minute. Etouffee sauce is what I put on there. And green onions and I had some smoked sausage I chop up in there and mix it in them cheese grits with that shrimp in the etouffee sauce on top. And it was damn good. I fried a couple of eggs and made some biscuits. And guess what I did? I was editing some of my SD cards. I guess y'all know what they are. That's what the camera's recording on right now. This is one. It's a 16 gigabyte. And I deleted it because I screwed up and put it on there with the brisket pit video that I did the other day. And I didn't realize I'd use the same card. I thought I'd swapped them, but I got confused. I got two of these 16 gig SD cards that I use. And in HD, I think I can get about 90 minutes on each one, so I only fill them up about half, not even half. Well, yeah, about halfway, because a lot of stuff gets deleted. Just, I'm going to get some salt. Okay, and I'm gone for a bit, you know. Maybe I had to walk to the pantry or go wash my hands or zip my pants back up or some shit like that, you know. So a lot of stuff gets chopped out, so I'll end up burning up about half a card or a good 45 minutes to shoot a 20-minute video, let's say. So we'll try it again, and hopefully we won't delete this one. I think this is only the second or third time that I've done that. And it was my own damn fault this time. It ain't happened no more. What we're going to make today is a Moroccan or Greek or Indian or Middle Eastern. Let's just say Middle Eastern dish. I've done it before, but I found a new recipe I want to try. And it's koftis. And basically, you can make them shish kebab style. And it's ground meat with spices. A lot of spices. Onions, garlic. I've been using onions, garlic, parsley, oregano, salt, pepper in the past, but this one adds in gram masala, if I'm saying that right, and I want to put a little bit of mint in it too, because I like mint. It just makes me think I'm eating lamb when I'm not, because I'm going to make it with some ground chuck, but I'm going to make a little burger patties, and we'll do some other shit with it. Just pay attention. All right, boys and girls, come around over here, camera boy. Follow me down here. Let's adjust you. You can get a little closer view of things that's happening. Reason I like this recipe is because of all the garlic it calls for. And Miss JB made some homemade ranch dressing the other day. and we're going to incorporate some of that into this. But first, we got to have one of these cold soldiers here. Freeze my teeth. And Miss JB gone. She went visit her mama, but she started talking about her hot flashes. Is it hot in the house? No, it ain't hot. I'm fine. And I told her something or another. I'm going to visit my mama. Goodbye. Go on. Go visit your mama. Your mama and them. So, we got a little food processor thingy here. And this is one of them little motorboats. And look, this one. Watch here. Back off, boy. This one actually comes apart. And you can put different heads on it. Like a little whisk beater thingy to do that with. Or a little food processor head. And who is made by Braun. Put that on there and get your shit in there. So we're going to make a little salad dressing. This is a hot garlic salad dressing. Garlic cloves. Some more. I need some of these for the meat, so we'll put, we better save the rest of them. We'll go on and put some of this, let me whisk this about the face. Use the baby fork. The babies ain't here either. Homemade ranch. Use that hidden secret mix, dry mix, and follow the directions. And it tastes like ranch. So, pour you some of that in there. It's like a lube job, you see. And I got some feta cheese that's packed in bran. Bran. The juice. And we want some of that juice in here. We also want some oregano. If you got fresh, go get it. I got some. I don't feel like going outside. It's too damn hot. You know, I got... With all the air conditioning I got, and you know I'm an air conditioning contractor, I can make it blow snow up in the house. And I know you people from up north and everywhere don't want to hear about that. I'm going to put a little pinch of mint. Now, we got to get some of that feta in there too. So, come here, feta. And another little hook. I think I'm gonna slice it across this way to keep what's left up under the brine. Going in there. Feta is very salty. And it's very good. Now we're gonna put this on now and pulse it after we plug it in. And who was that said, these still are two available? Yeah, boy. I found these at the Walgreens. It's that non-union drugstore. Pulsing. My ass. Just turn the son of a bitch on. Now that dressing is hot with garlic. We also got to get some EVOO in there. But you don't want to put that in when you're grinding all that stuff up. Because you can bruise it. I'm serious. And it can become bitter. Now we're pulsing. Right? Now this, watch your fingers if you're going to stick them in there to blaze sharp. One of the best salad dressings you'll ever have in your life. Maybe I ought to bottle it and sell it. Yum. Yum, yum, yum. This little thingy here come with a lid to save it on. You can put that in the fridge and let it mind meld like the Vulcan mind meld. Full of, oh, get that sauce off of that lens. It may like it. So we got an onion. We're gonna peel the onion. Get all the skin off, boy. And now we're gonna grate it. And try not to grate your knuckles while you're grating the damn onion. But you won't be happy with your damn self. Or should I say your damn fool self? So grate the onion up and cry. So that's what's gonna happen. And no, sunglasses ain't gonna help. Only thing you could do is put on a gas mask because it's going in your sinuses. Blow a fan at it. And blow that smell away. Wah, wah. See, I'm already starting to cry. I don't have a fan on. Got onion jizz on my hands too. Let me finish grating
this. I'm crying now.
My eyes is watering. Can you see them? Got that onion all grated up. And you move over here. We need to smash some garlic up. Down there, boy. It's all in your sinuses. That's what makes you cry. Oh, your eyes water. Oh, wah, oh, wah, oh, wah. My butt. I'm telling you, that I ain't crying. Look, a meat, a hammer. Yeah. Smash some garlic. All right. Do some more. If you got a garlic press, you can do this, too. I like just whooping on it with a goddamn hammer. I said, got. Not God. I don't like cursing him. Lightning can come through the roof. And then bust it up some more. Is this gonna have a lot of garlic in it? Oh, hell yeah. Do I have, ooh, yeah. Got garlic jizz on my finger. Ooh, yum. I love garlic. This is what struck my eye about this recipe. That amount of onion and the garlics. I got the bullshit Emily posts up now. Jimmy, how much you had to drink? I don't know. About 10 or 12 soda pops. Are they diet soda? Yeah. They diet sodas. Actually, I got some diet water for sale too. And I can save some. I even got some instant diet water. Comes in a little package. All you do is add water. Yum. Alright. So let's go on and put that whooped up garlic in there. All of it. You can probably grill that plate and eat it. Put some pepper. Put some salt. A little more salt. Oh, put some oregano. I like that. See, that's onion juice down in there. See that? Snort that and see if you cry. Oh, you'd be so stupid for doing that, that you'd never do it again. A little pinch of mint. Maybe another half a pinch. What are we looking for? Look down there, down there. Got some grind chuck. It says 1.995 pounds. All right, so there you go. And what we're doing here is making a sausage with just meat and all that seasoning that's in there. Oh, we're supposed to put this Graham Marsala in there. Oh, you can smell this through the package. I mean, through both bags that was in. This is a combination blend, Graham Marsala. And it said to put 4 tablespoons. I think that's going to be too much, because this shit is fresh and strong like a little brand new puppy dog. So we ain't going to put that full amount in there. They were talking about 4 tablespoons, but I know better than that. Maybe if you got some old dried Graham Marsala that had been sitting around for since Grandpa's grandpa. Yeah, you may put 4 tablespoons. But don't add this much of this when it's fresh ground like that. So we're gonna put 1 heaping teaspoon. And I'm thinking that cool y'all, man. All right, 1 heaping, as promised. Stuff's strong. That knocked the tears out of my eyes strong, I'm telling you right now. So we're gonna mix up and form some patties. Then we're gonna go put them in the fridge and let them firm up. And we go grill them. All right, so that's what's, look down there, don't look at my zipper. All right, so once you made all your patties, press them in the center, because they're gonna shrink. And you don't want them to form little meatballs. And look, I got a little sampler right here that I'm gonna cook beforehand to make sure these have enough seasoning on them, in them. And if they need more salt or something like that before I go grill them, I can just apply some more seasoning to the outside of them, and that should do it. But I'm pretty sure just smelling this, I can smell salt. And these freeze really well. Well, what I'm gonna do first is go put these in a cold fridge, my beer fridge, and let them firm up. That way when we put them on a grill, it'll be rock and roll, my friend. I completely forgot, man. This has gotta have a lot of parsley in it. And that's that much. So let me get that mixed in. Got the burgers. They're still gelatinous. How you call them? So mix that in there. And get the parsley mixed in it. You gotta have that. You can also put cilantro in there. But I'm gonna go ahead and do it with just the parsley. That's all I got. So I'm gonna chop up some green onions and white onions. And we're gonna put a little bit of EVOO No 2 in there and make us a little rice and pilaf. Okay? Garlic gotta go in here too. You know that gotta go. So we're gonna saute this down a little bit. And we're gonna add some garlic. some garlic going in there. You knew it was coming. Got a little bit of sweat down time. And boy, it smells fragrant in here. Put you a little bit of salt and pepper in here. Got some peas and carrots right here. Right here. Yeah, right. It's gone. And, oh, what's wrong with this pitcher? Got to measure some of the juice out of here into that. Measuring. That's your vegetable stock. All right. Wear that around a little bit. Got that much. So we're gonna put 2 cups of water for 1 cup of rice in here. There you go, 2 cups. Stir it around, look, the knife's upside down. Well, I'm not dulling the blade, boy. Now we gotta get some salt in here. I want beef stock. So I've chosen these little cube cow pieces. Put them in there. That should be enough. Let's bring that to a barrel. And we'll go fire up our BBQ pit. Cool, huh? Okay, so let's go ahead and pour 1 cup of rice in here. Stir it around, bring it back to the barrel, and let it simmer for 20 minutes. I've got to go ahead and put some these peas and carrots in there. And we're going to cut the heat back and simmer this for 20 minutes. Covered. So let's build us a little salad here. Got some red onion and some green bell pepper. And we'll put these fresh hamburger buns right on top. And get us some centrifuge salad pieces, parts out of here. And the wife back there trying to bathe a puppy dog that being non-union, that'd be all right. Okay. Hey, you want it torn fine or tear? Or just eat it, bite it. Who cares? Let's get us some non-Greek olives. Just some olives. Put you some on there. Now let's go ahead and put some feta cheese on there. And then pour that hot garlic, recording stupid, good. Pour that hot garlic dressing on top and lick a little bit off. Yum, boy. We're going to mix that in just a little bit. That stuff rocks. Mix that in and maybe get a little taste. Uh-huh. Look here. Yum. Yum. Mix that all up. And we're going to put some red onions and bell pepper slice up on there. And, oh yeah, fix it all pretty. Make it look nice. All we got to do is go get them burgers off the grill. And they've been grilling and making some little burgers. And I forgot, and pour the rest of that salad dressing on there. Oh, hell yeah. Use it all. Throw it all over the damn counter. I forgot to show the damn rice pilaf, but don't worry, it got it. And it was some fine. And it's a good salad. Healthy for you, too. Put cucumbers on there if you want. I don't care. Now you can add pine nuts to the salad, into the burger meat, and on the pilaf into it. Do use the good imported ones. Don't get the ones from China. They're, trust me, I can't have nuts no more. And I love them, but man, it'd be good. Put any kind of nuts on there if you want.